I'm out.
Your keys in it, your wallet's in it too.
Cool. Taking Ava?
Yeah, I guess she'd go away for the day.
Cool. Alright.
Where you going?
Work out. Do you want to go work out?
What?
Do you want to go work out?
I'll work out later.
Alright. It's now like almost 1 o'clock and kind of done. Solutions. Finished up all the launch madness, like 10 a.m. launching thing from the house. And I like staying home when I launch because I can't deal with like distractions. And so I have to kind of like be alone in my house, nice, peace and quiet, and I'm able to get the most amount of work done in the most efficient way possible. So now I'll take the gym to hit a leg day and check on the warehouse. Launch day. So guys, telling family back to the commentary for y'all, and real quick, if you want to see the conversation, so I titled the video something like getting, you know, getting off my chest, or I don't know, whatever the title is, it's going to be related to the talk at the end of this video. So skip forward to 21 minutes. So if you just fast forward to the 21 minute mark, that's where I start that talk. The second thing is this is a longer video. I think it's around 25, 26 minutes. So just sit back, relax, and enjoy this video. And I didn't want to cut much out. I wanted to like leave my whole workout. I was hanging out with Dad and Nala and stuff and wanted to leave a lot of those clips in. And so that's why this video is a little bit longer. So let me know the feedback. Let me know if you like, you know, maybe once or twice a week I can post a 25 to 30 minute video. Other times I'll be posting a 10 to 12 minute. And yeah, just let me know what you like. So started this workout out with squat. Here you're seeing 405 pounds. And here's my fourth rep right there. And I think that this, oh, that's my third, yeah, fourth rep. That is the cleanest I've ever done four reps before. I feel like my form looked better on that first set than it ever has for four reps. And my all-time PR is 5 reps with 405. And so I hit 4, again, much slower, more controlled. I feel like my form was better. And here was my second set, which I wasn't as happy with the form, and I was able to get 3 reps. But one thing I've noticed, I've really been evaluating my squat form. I've been like watching the footage back and everything. And even like I can tell because I kind of feel it happen. I feel like I let my chest, you know, one of the cues you're supposed to try to remind yourself of is chest up, right? So you're coming down, your knees are pushing outwards, your chest stays up, your head stays neutral. I've been letting my chest kind of come down, and therefore I feel like I'm using more of my lower back to get the weight up. And so I was really trying to on this workout to focus on keeping my chest up as much as possible. And so that's what I'm gonna be emphasizing over the next few weeks. Yeah, chest up. So here's, I dropped the weight down after my second set of 405 and did 315. I think I got like 8 reps. And so here you can see the form, you know, obviously with the lighter weight, it's easier to make your form a little better. But, you know, I want to get 405 to look as smooth as possible eventually. But here's 315 for a few reps. And I felt really good. I didn't have much to eat. I literally had like 2 eggs and a protein shake before the workout. So I was really happy with it. And I'm currently weighing in. I feel like I'm fluctuating a lot, but I weighed in at 187.0 last night. And so therefore I would say like my morning body weight on an empty stomach is somewhere around 184-ish, maybe. Yeah, 184. With that said, I am going to continue my bulk until mid-March. And that's when I'm going to start Summer Shredding 2017. And I am so pumped. I've got something that I'm really excited to tell you guys about. I'll probably announce that announcement maybe before February, but I guess I'll give you a little sneak peek. A little hint is if you guys want to cut, I would recommend waiting until about March 14th, March 15th, day one of Summer Shredding. That's your hint. Okay. So keep bulking, do your thing. And that is when I recommend you start if you want. Yeah. Just that's all I'll say. Okay. So, second exercise was a seated hamstring curl. You can see here, I'm really just focused on, well, first when I get in the seat, I bring the pad down right above my knee as much as possible. Like I make it uncomfortably like tight, and that just helps me keep my form really tight as well. I focus a lot on negatives, so bringing the weight down, pausing for a second, pulling through my heel. So as I'm coming down, I'm literally thinking heel to ass. I'm trying to make my heel touch my butt and come downwards. And so once I get to the final position, the flex position, I squeeze, one Mississippi, two Mississippi, then let up slow and focus on the negative. Same here with the quad extensions, that same sort of tempo. So explode up, squeeze, down. Explode up, squeeze, down. I kind of started going fast towards the end there. But squat, I only did 3 sets, but on the hamstring and on the quad, I did 5 working sets apiece. And the third movement that I did was a, oh, it's coming up here. It was a variation, a lying leg press, I guess you could call it, the leg press machine, which I haven't done too often at the gym, but I realized that the cable is a little bit like, it's a little jerky, and so I need to get that fixed. But I was really trying to, you know, again, focus on the negative. And I kept my hoodie on during this workout. I put my phone up, kept my hoodie on, and I think that even though it was about 76 degrees outside, but in the warehouse, it's just like brutal. And so the hoodie just like made it really tough, but I felt really good with that hoodie on. And so it was hot, but I just felt amazing. And so I kept it on for my whole workout. I was drenched and it was really good. So here I focused with my squat. I went pretty heavy-ish, nothing over like 8 reps. And so here I went like 10 to 15 reps on my sets, or my reps, yeah, my sets. And you can see here, just coming really down slow, pausing at the bottom and exploding up. And yeah, what's my next movement? And what else do I want to talk about? Let me see. Yeah, really give me your feedback, guys, about the longer videos. I would appreciate that. I think that a mix could be really nice. Maybe like, you know, 1 or 2 videos a week, where, or maybe 1 video a week where it's like 30 minutes. And then maybe, you know, majority of my videos, the engagement is, just statistically, the engagement is higher if the video is shorter. So if it's like a 10 to 12 minute video, typically people watch the videos for longer. I'm pretty positive. But I know a lot of you guys do enjoy the longer vlogs. And personally, like whenever I'm doing cardio and stuff, I love watching 20 to 30 minute videos. So I know I said that during summer shredding, I'll do more of that, and I will. So during summer shredding, when I'm doing a video every day for 90 days, that's going to be a challenge first off, but I'm really excited for that challenge. And I'm going to try to bring you guys the best content, the most engaging, the most informative. Obviously, the content's going to be more focused on fitness during that time versus, I guess, like right now is a little bit more lifestyle. There's a lot of stuff going on, I'm saying. But yeah, so I'm excited for that time to come, which will again be March 14th, March 15th, around then. So 2 calf movements. And last thing I want to say is that I will be at the Arnold, Ohio. I think I got a 10 by 20. We're going to have some Alfleet Ohio Arnold t-shirts. And then the team Alfleet will be at Australia, the Arnold in Australia. So we're literally going Ohio and then Australia. But thank you guys for watching and enjoy the rest of the video. I haven't seen the family since before the LA Fit Expo. So I'm stopping by the house to see everybody, or see who's home. And see Nala and Knox. Oh, they didn't see me. Okay. Hey, Knox. Hi. What's up? Hey, girls. Hey, girls. Hey, girls. Nothing. What's up?
Some rice.
Yeah. I'm about to. Hi! Hi! Yeah, I just worked out. Hi!
Come on,
Alan, come on!
Chicken, you bitch. Good girl. No, Knox.
You guys see this? You can see the snow flying everywhere. I am covered.
No doctors? They're on time, right?
Yeah, they're good. I got an email last week, so they probably do soon.
You gotta get him professionally brushed.
Yeah. Joe's allergic to the hair.
Joe is?
Yeah.
Really? Mm. How's he doing?
Good. You guys beg too much. Nala begs too much.
Shit. I'm not giving you all. Nope. Just a little bit.
That's right, John.
Come on,
Nala. Let's go.
Come on.
But we can't get Knox out.
Come on.
I'm in shock. There, Dad.
No, that's okay. You know what? Go through the garage better, son. Oh, Christian's taking Nala to the house. To this house. Vente, vente. Mente, vente. I know she's gonna die, dude. She's gonna die. That's okay, I'm gonna get your leash. No. Hold on. No, no. No, wait, 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 wait. Oh my God. No. Stop. Hold on. Stop. How you gonna fit her in there, man? Stop! Nah, you gonna get on Ferrari? Damn! Look at that.
We're gonna go for... I'm gonna take Nala home for a few, maybe a day, a night or two, see how she does. Knox is freaking out, but she'll be okay. Dad's gonna walk her and stuff later. And
yeah, I'm gonna take her for a walk right now.
Yeah, I'm gonna see how Nala does first, because Nala's a little bit more like, she's older, she's more tamed, and then we're gonna...
Look at that, Nala in the Ferrari, blue eyes.
Yeah, I'm gonna lower the window and we'll get a picture.
Knox is dying over there.
I know, I feel bad.
That's okay, I'll take her for a walk, she'll be happy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
You want to take a picture?
No, that's right, just hold it right there.
Oh, look at that. Hey, Nala, going for a cruise with a boy.
All right, so I'm going to take Nala home. All right, Dad, I'll see you later.
Okay, man.
All right.
Hey, let's do some lunch.
Recording.
Yeah. You drove here yet or what?
No, I'll probably see her this week.
Hey, well, let us know, man.
Okay.
Cruise you by the house, go see Ava.
Yeah, all right.
I'm going to take it for a walk. This
okay. There we are. And it's funny, my range is actually in the shop, guys. It had to get some work done, and so I don't have it. Therefore, I'm in the 458, and we are about to go to my house. Nala's never been, and I brushed her, gave her a good brush. I'm gonna keep her for the day at the house, and I'm gonna see how Joe is, because Joe's actually allergic to Nala's hair. but he's not like two, it's just kind of like, you know, mild allergies. So if he's okay, she can stay the night with me in my room. But if he's just like dying, then I'll probably bring her back later tonight. But I'm gonna spend the day with her, take her for a walk. It's been a long week. If you guys are, you know, tuned in the channel, it's been a lot, you know, so I just wanna take her for a walk and maybe go for like a run or something with her and enjoy it. So, you ready now? Watch out, watch out.
And then here's Dad. Straight chilling.
When she was a puppy, she'd always put her face like right into the air vent. So I'm gonna turn it up for her. Right here.
There you go.
I swear she has like this instinct, and she knows when we're getting close. She was like laying down a second ago, and she knows we're getting close. She gets super antsy every time. Every time. Come on. I'm gonna take her out back first. This way, this way. This way, this way. Come on. Hey, let's go back here. Come on. This way. This way.
He shot the bear.
This fence is so short. Check it out. Hinala, this was used as a child, as an infant. Here's a picture of Heidi and I doing a helicopter ride. Wanna check it upstairs? This way. This way. Nala, come on. She thought she was going to fall down. Oh, man. Mini heart attack. Up here, Nala. Come on. Up here. I know a lot of people don't let their dogs on the bed, but Nala is definitely used to being on the bed. Come on. We're gonna go ahead and make some pasta because that's really all I have. And I feel like having some pasta. I'm gonna have a protein shake and pasta. So we've got some hot water, almost boiling. And the first thing I'm gonna add is this stuff right here. Knorr chicken broth. So I'll just pour a little bit of that in here. I'm gonna make the whole box, so I kinda put a lot, but I'll wait for that to boil. She found her spot. I'm gonna eat the whole box, so 56 grams of protein, 336 grams of carbs, 16 grams of fiber, 8 grams of fat. And now I'm gonna put some, I can't believe it's not butter, on here. I was giving Joe crap this morning for like making a mess cooking. Mm. This is not the healthiest meal. This is not the most micronutrient dense meal, I know. But it's what I got at the house and I'm really hungry, guys. So I'm gonna eat this. I'm sure some of you can relate. And I'm not a huge sauce guy. I mean, I like sauce, but I'm totally cool with like butter noodles with cheese like that.
Ava's not feeding her.
No.
She doesn't have a...
She doesn't have Knox.
I think it's Knox and Ava are the ones that are playing.
440 La La Land.
Yeah, we'll get the tickets in advance.
Okay.
And we'll see you tomorrow.
All right, I'll be there.
Okay.
Cool.
Love you,
love you. All right, so I'm about to head out tonight. Go out with some friends. It's me, myself, Taylor, Taylor's friend, Shali, Javon, and Daniel tonight. And we couldn't convince Joe to go out. He might go out, probably not. But I figured I'd show you guys what I'm wearing real quick, even though it's really low light. Got an Alphalete scoop neck in large with the pocket right here. I've got my favorite movement watch. This is like my top two for sure. I always wear this one, tan, because I always wear the tan Chelsea boots, so it matches. And some Oro. It's Oro, O-R-O, Los Angeles jeans. They're good jeans, but they, they had great service. I would say they had great service, but it took me a long, it was not the best service, but the jeans are pretty cool. So, yeah, I'm working out tonight, and I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow morning, and pick up the vlog, and we'll finish the vlog off tomorrow, so I'll see you then.
How are you feeling with Nala? Bro, I don't know. Like, I need to go to a doctor because I don't know how I can just be huskies.
Yeah.
Like, what is it about a husky?
But it's like right, bad.
Last night my eyes were like bloodshot as fuck.
Yeah.
But it was because I was like petting her and then I like scratched my eye.
Oh.
Like, as long as I like.
Don't just don't really her and don't me, roll around with her.
Pretty much.
Yeah. But Joe got the new laptop. This is what, the 15-inch,
yeah,
decked out, touch bar, specced out, really good.
It's fast.
Silver one?
Yeah, they didn't have a gray one.
With no plugs, you gotta get all the plugs, but really, I just need this plug. I actually ordered the dark space, or the dark gray space gray one with the same spec, which is coming on January 24th, 24. I'm gonna take her for a walk around here and see if she likes it. There's like a little trail. I think it's like a 2-mile trail. So we're gonna go for a 2-mile walk. Maybe I'm exaggerating, I don't know.
Okay, YouTube, so I tried recording a clip while I was walking Nala, but it was just too windy outside, and so I'm gonna re-record it right now. She sounds like a horse, just like. So I'm gonna talk right now. And so, this overall message is thank you, pretty much, but I wanna kind of talk about this week and voice some of my thoughts to you guys and just open up a little bit more. And so this week, you heard me say yesterday something about this week has been like a little, you know, not the best week. And to be honest, it really, you know, it hasn't been. There's been a lot of negativity. There's been this, there's been that. It's all just like stuff you can block, right? But at a certain point, you know, it is kind of hard to deal with. And so, like, I get it. Nikki and I dated for 2 years. We broke up, got back together. So there you're looking at a time frame of about 2.5 years. And both of our growths, like majority of our channel growth was during those 2.5 years. Just naturally, like that's when everything hit for both of us and we gained hundreds of thousands of subscribers. And so like I understand the ties and like the connection and like the attachment and like, I get it. And even with Heidi, like Heidi was dating Josh before she even started a YouTube channel. Any sort of change is always difficult, but one thing I want to say is just that anything can be shown in any light that you want to portray on social media. So on YouTube or on Instagram, like you can make anything look perfect. And it's not always the case. You know, on social media, you literally see highlights. You see like these cute pictures and like this, and you see, you know, good little clips, and like it kind of builds this thing in viewers' heads, you know. But then real life, obviously you're not gonna say like, hey YouTube, like we're really fighting right now, like we've had a really rough week, like, you know, we're doing this and that. Like, you're not gonna say that, you know? And so I think that real life versus the social media, it's not always the same. And I think that people sometimes have some difficulty like realizing that not everything is shown and like that's not real, you know? And not that it's not real, but it is a little bit skewed no matter what. Even my videos, like, I don't record all the time. I don't record when I'm feeling like, not too great. You know, most of the time I'm just like doing highlights, try to keep the video as engaging as possible, right? And like positive and uplifting and stuff. And Heidi and I decided to come out public about everything because it had already been a while. We were getting a lot of negativity from trying to hide it and trying to keep it. And also like not even just talking about others' opinions and stuff, but like we were ready. It was so hard to like not vlog and not be normal and like telling all our friends, hey, do you like, don't mind, can you not post that? Can you not take that picture? Can you like maybe delete that off your Snapchat? Like stuff like that. It just got to the point where it was like, no man, like we're really happy right now and we didn't intend for this to happen and we're gonna go with it. And I know I didn't touch on this in my last video, but Heidi kind of did in her video. But Heidi and Nikki were friends. They were friends about 3 years ago, the end of their friendship, but they were friends. You know, does that look bad? Is that bad on image? Is that a bad look? Like, yes, it is. And though they haven't been friends in those years, like, you know, girl code and bro code and all this stuff, it's like, I get it. It's legit, like, I understand. But at the same time, neither of us intended that this to happen. We didn't intend to be here, like, together and all this stuff. And I think at some point you have to say, like, man, every move I make is not gonna be for my freaking image. Every move I make, like if something legitimately makes me really happy, like I'm enjoying time here doing this, I'm investing in this person, like it's going amazing, but it doesn't give me the best look. You know, like sometimes you have to go with what actually makes you happy in real life. Ideally, we would both of us would have found one person, dated them our entire YouTube career for the rest of our lives, and just like have our following, just love every, like love that relationship and be perfect and everything. But the truth is, like, we're both growing up, and sometimes there's nothing wrong with certain people. Sometimes people just don't mix together. And I'm not trying to bash anybody or anything like that. It's just sometimes two individuals do not, like, it's not permanent, and that's okay. There's someone out there that is supposed to be with that person. Like I said, this clip is really just to say thank you for the support you have shown. And I think that sometimes you have to undergo some negativity, some hate and everything to appreciate the love and support that is shown. So thank you guys. And I can't speak for everybody else involved in the situation, but all I ask is that you guys be open-minded. And again, thank you for your support. And I will see you in the next video. I don't mean to be like, this isn't like a negative thing, all right? I'm in a good mood. Just wanted to verbalize like what's been going on the last few days. So thank you guys again, and I will see you tomorrow or the next day.